Welcome to this DC Universe Online live stream let's play. You're with Sambo and of course Dfinity, looking splendid and pink. Oh dear, pink follows me around, I swear. Standing behind me are the mighty Superzeroes here in Centennial Park under, well, I think it's Superman around here. Let's see if we can get a hello out of the Superzeroes who are joining us in voice chat. Hello, Superzeroes!
Hello!
There they are. Hello. Look at this, will you? Now, do you know what? It's tradition, of course, for the mighty Superzeroes to have some kind of event going on, and you know what, in the background there we've definitely got an event today. And let's see, who can I pick on down here? Oh, here we go, here's somebody. Kazin, how are you, sir?
Good, how are you?
Very well. Actually, look, do you want to hop down the front here with me? In fact, you can come over to this bridge. I want you to show off your outfit today while we explain what's going on. And in fact, Chulma, I can see Chulma in the background. Hey, Chulma.
Hello.
Do you want to hop over here as well, if you don't mind? Because Chulma, as you guys will know, if you've read the thread on our Superzeroes website, Chulma kind of goes ahead and organizes all these crazy events. So before we go any further, Chulma, today is called Cowboys and Indians. Explain to us, why are we here? What is this Cowboys and Indians thing? Is it like Cowboys and Indians from our childhood? Explain yourself.
Well, okay, before I explain myself, how was your Thanksgiving?
Oh, my Thanksgiving. Well, you know what? We don't celebrate it over here, but I celebrated it vicariously through everybody in the US, so thanks, guys.
Well, the Thanksgiving is what made me decide to make Cowboy vs. Indian today. Oh, and Mind Blast inspired it, too. But we decided that since Thanksgiving just passed, this would be a good way to celebrate it.
Well, game, at least. That is a good way of celebrating it. So, Kazin, I'm having a look at you here. Now, I don't know. Are you a cowboy or are you an Indian?
I am an Indian.
You are an Indian. You look good. You've got the mohawk going on there. You've got the war paint. You've got your arrows. That's awesome. How long did it take you to do that?
Not long. Probably 10 minutes or something.
It looks really good. So I'm guessing everyone behind us here has also got themselves in a cowboy and Indian outfit. Now, hang on, Chulma. Before we go check out the rest of the mighty Superzeroes in the background there, are you cowboy or are you Indian?
I'm an Indian. This is the last minute outfit I whipped up. It's probably not as good as everybody else's.
So it's an Indian that you found just lying around, like the outfit you just... something you threw on last minute. Is that how it works?
Yep.
Fantastic. And let's have a look quickly before we go and check out the mighty Superzeroes in the background there. Let's go to the YouTube chat, because remember, folks, we are live. This is our second ever live stream for our DC Universe Online League event, and we love these because they're chaotic and fun and you never know what's going to happen. So joining us, I can see a few people in the chat room there. We've got Elgo, hello there, who's that? Elgon01, good to see you. Starlin23, who's saying that they're actually in game as well. And do you know what, I've got a funny feeling Star might be in voice chat. Are you there, Star?
Then I am.
That you are. Look at that, it's the woman that denied my hand in marriage in all the games I've ever proposed to her in. Good to see you. Now, hopefully, are you actually standing behind us there somewhere? Because I'd love to come over and see your outfit. Are you there? In game?
Standing next to Blaze Leather.
There you go, fantastic. We'll come over and see you in just a second. Who else have we got there? MG Swift Illusion, who's saying, hey guys, another wonderful DCUO stream. You better believe it. You never know what's going to happen with these crazy folk in the DCUO league that we have going here. Of course, the Superzeroes. EZO119, a big hello to you. And SuperHHNBK, who says, I love Superzeroes. You know what? I don't think you're the only one around here. Who's that? Chronic Fate XX. Hey there, how's it going? Fat Man Ralphie, and of course we know that Fat Man Ralphie is that crazy English guy with the crazy dice, none other than Fair Blitz, and I'm sure you're there in voice chat. Fair, hello.
Hello.
Oh, you are there. Do you know what? I can see your dice. Oh, you've just tried to hide it from me. I can tell. I can see your dice in the background there. So we'll come over and say good day to you in a second. 10 Cent 6, hello there. Look at this. 10 Cent 6 in the live stream is saying, hey, shame on you, Starlin. Yes, that's what I say all the time to her. She just refuses to marry me. Oh, I don't know. Just like real life, I think it is. All right, so big hello, and of course, we do love you guys joining us from the... yeah, big grins there from Starlin. Joining us in the chat room there, and we will try and keep an eye on that. Well, Kazin, I think it's time to hop over and see some of the crazy creations that we've got going on here from the folk in the league. What do you reckon? Let's have a look over here. Because I think...
Can I come too?
Yeah, you can come as well. Come and let's have a look at this. Because you know what? Folks put a lot of time and effort into these costumes. And we like to give them their due. So now I'm going to wander down the line and say g'day. And we're going to just quickly highlight everybody's costume here. If you're in voice chat and I say g'day, please, as always, just interrupt me and say hello so that I know you're there. But look at this, Wing Nature. You know what, that's a really cool one, because they've actually got...
Hi, Samba.
Oh, it's you. It's the woman that refuses to marry me, is that right? There you go. In fact, you know what, I'm going to come over here and stand right next to you. Let's have a look at this. So this is a very cool outfit. Do you know what this reminds me of? It reminds me of an old school, like 20s or 30s cowboy sort of, you know, western type thing. Any inspiration for you from this with this costume?
I tried to go with as much stuff that looked cowboyish as I could.
Well, you know what? I think it worked. It's great. It really does look good. Now, if anybody's watching along from home and they want to know where to get that hat, do you remember where you got it from?
Not too sure where I got it from. I think it might have been a drop at one point.
It's at Area 51 briefings.
There you go.
Oh, it's the briefings?
Do you know what, Kazin?
Briefings from Area 51.
Kazin, you're like a walking DCUO Wikipedia, I think. That's what you are. Now, by the way, I've got a task for you guys in the YouTube live chat room. Again, this is only our second ever DC Universe Online live stream. So we're still playing with the settings. If the game volume is too loud, if you'd like me to mute myself, I'm sure a lot of people would love that. Or if you can't hear the guys in the league, let me know in chat and we can adjust the volumes on the fly. It's no problem. All right, good to see you, Star. One day you shall be mine. Oh, yes. We will see. Quakers.
Sorry, but I like being single.
She always says that. Kazin, what do you reckon? Is it me, do you think, Kazin? Is it just me?
It has to be.
It has to be me. There we go. Philip. Who's that? Philip El Mote. Hope I'm saying your name right there. A dictionary. That's right, Kazin is a dictionary. In fact, you know what? We've got a whole bunch of walking dictionaries here in the league. It's fantastic. I can see Trick Bite. Look at that. Great costume. I can see Blazing Leather. Now, that's an awesome outfit as well. Look at that with the cowboy. You know, is that the same hat that Starlin's got on there, Kazin, that Blazing Leather has? It's very cool.
Yes, it looks the same.
Yeah, except it's dyed purple, my favorite color. We've got, Who else? Oh, look at this. I can see a familiar face. This is someone who's joined us in many of our events, and that would be Lady Solara. Are you there?
Yes, sir.
You are there. Gosh, you know what? This game is very noisy. Do you know what? I'm just going to quickly break the fourth wall. You guys know I do this all the time in my streams. And we're going to... What are we going to do? We need to probably turn up Mumble just a little bit. I'd hate you guys not to be able to hear our wonderful Superzeroes. There we go. That's a bit better. All right. So Lady Solara, got to say, if I can zoom in here. Now, don't get me wrong here, but you look like you're dressed up as a classic wench from a saloon in the Old West. Now, would that be right?
Yes, sir.
All right, good. That is, you know what, it really, really does look like that. And again, for me to be able to guess that means that your costume must be awesome, because I'm terrible with stuff like that. So if anyone wants to know, do you know the name of the pieces that you've got on there? Because that really does look like a wench from a saloon. It's fantastic. What are you wearing?
I'm trying to remember. It's the metalhead top, the formal gloves, the wizardly legs, the thigh-high boots, and then the split back.
Okay. Oh, now, what do you reckon, Chilma? Marks out of 10 for Lady Solara's costume?
Only 10? I'm going to give her 100.
100 out of 10? That's a pretty mighty score. Well-deserved, lady. And now we're going to be doing an instance later on. There you go, folks, if you're watching along from home. Today, you don't want to miss this one. We're doing a really cool instance, one that we've only done once before on the Let's Play series, and it was very rough. But I think, lady, you're not joining us in that one today, are you?
Nope.
Okay, so wish me luck, will you? I'm going to need all of it. I'm not going to have you beside me, so... Oh dear, I'm terrible at the best of times. This one is fun though, and I think the last time we did it, I did actually survive, so I don't know, we're going in with
yes,
a good track
record.
I did survive. Now, by the way, speaking of that, who is that?
That's Star Kestrel, who ran it with you last time.
That's right. In fact, I can see you right there. Let's stand next to you. Now, again, great looking costume here. Look at this, folks. Do you know what? I'm going to say something here, and yeah, I take one look at your costume, and I think of one character, and it's from a Western, but it's not a old school Western. It's from what I call a sci-fi Western. Now, I'm going to take anyone in voice chat. If you can pick up on where I'm going, you're welcome to try and give this a guess. But I reckon this character looks very, very much like somebody from a space Western that I'm a big fan of. Now, any clues?
Firefly.
Oh, who said that? That's got to be Star. See, that is why I want to marry this woman, because you got it in one. Seriously, Star Kestrel, I reckon you... Now, who's that firing their guns? It's a flying gangster. That is so loud. Good Lord. Star Kestrel, you look like Malcolm Reynolds. Was that deliberate?
Yes, it was.
Woo!
In fact, I had to tweak the coat a little once I got into Metropolis, because I had originally put it together in Gotham, and it looked darker in there.
You know what? It's funny you should say that, because when you, it does depend where you are. The lighting does affect. It does actually affect the look of your outfit. And gosh, listen to that. That is the crazy Superzeroes in the background there, folks. They are making all sorts of noise. That's what we love, though. It's total mad. Kestrel, how long did it take you to put that together? Or should I say Malcolm Reynolds? Captain Tight Pants?
Yeah, not too long, actually. It was, the tricky part was figuring out which trench coat style looked closest.
Yeah, definitely. Look, you know what? We've got Philippe. Who's that? Philippe in the YouTube live stream chat. And he's saying cowboy versus aliens guy. You know what? That's a really good guess, actually. If it wasn't Malcolm Reynolds, it would be that guy. That's very good. Have you seen that movie too, Star Kestrel? Cowboys and Aliens?
Not really. I keep meaning to and then never got around to it.
Yeah, it's pretty cool. It's got Harrison Ford in it. Indiana Jones himself, so there you go. Now, who else have we got around here?
And James Bond.
And James Bond. That's right. Definitely. So some big names in there.
Daniel Craig.
And Daniel Craig, that's it. James Bond himself. Monster Jerk down there. Now, I must say, Monster Jerk isn't looking very cowboy and Indian, but he still looks pretty awesome and looks pretty evil, if you ask me, with his clown face going on there. We've got Beyblade in. Who else? We've got Chilmer, of course. We've got Mind Blaster. Now, does Mind Blaster join us in chat? Hey there. Now, if I can get out of here. Do you know what? I always get stuck amongst our wonderful folk here. Let's see if we can get over here. Go. All right, finally made it. Although I'm standing on your head. Sorry about that, Mind Blaster. Let's see if I can get out of here. There we go. All right, now, you are definitely looking very cowboy and Indian. Do you want to explain your outfit to us?
Well, the cowboy hat is from the Area 51 briefings. I picked up the buckaroo shirt and shoulders and boots from the marketplace, and I'm wearing a Wall Street skirt. My leggings.
Yes, I recognize that one, actually. I've got that on a couple of my characters. Oh, excellent job, as always. You know what? It's this hat. I need to get me one of these hats, don't I? Especially for this event. Because everyone's wearing one, and I don't have one. Although, maybe I do. I'm not sure. In fact, hang on. Who can talk me through this? In fact, you can. You will do this, Mind Blaster. Yeah, you've got the duty, because you're the last person I spoke to. If I wanted to check, in fact, we can show folks from home how this works. If I wanted to check if I had that hat in my styles, walk me through it. How would I do that?
I usually go to inventory, so press I on your keyboard.
Here we go, folks. I, yep.
And then go down to style, which is the mask icon.
Rightio, here we go. I'm in my styles. Now, by the way, you do realize that I never, ever, ever change my style. So this is a big thing, right? This is a big thing for me. So, you know, I'm trying to keep my emotions in cap here. All right, I've got hair, head, face, accessory, etc.
You want the head.
Want the head? All right, so do I click on the little arrow?
Click on the little arrow.
All right.
And then, I don't know about you, but I have 15 pages of head styles.
Excuse me. Did you say 15?
15, yes.
Did you hear that, guys? That 15, that is ridiculous. Thank you, everyone in the chat room. Yes, definitely go to Stars. I have a grand total of 2. What do you reckon? That's pretty awesome, isn't it?
Well,
oh, dear.
Nothing. I have 18.
What?
Now, luckily, they are in alphabetical order, okay. So all you have to do is look for cowboy.
Oh, Can you believe this? Mine goes barbarian, biker, contemporary tech, and then demonic. So it's not going to appear on page 2. Now let me click on page... No, it's not. Oh, so that means I don't have the cowboy hat. Man! Okay, well, I'm just going to have to look at everybody else's hats. That's terrible. Well, thanks for letting us know, anyway. Never mind.
We'll have to take you through Area 51 just for the briefings.
Yeah, just so I can get me a hat. Well, there you go. And that goes to show why it's important to complete those briefings. In fact, Kazin is the only reason I don't have the hat, because I haven't completed that briefing. Would that be right?
That is correct.
All right, so there you go. Normally I'm a completionist, but it's a shiny that I haven't found. Terrible me. All right, I can see the Ultra Prodigy there. They're looking very cool, although they do have pink hair. There we go. The pink is following me around everywhere. We've got TOR Clockwise, who is looking... They're looking like a cat today. Very cool. In fact, let's give these guys a wave. There we go. Are you in voice chat, Clockwise? No?
Yes, I am.
Oh, hello. All right, now you need to explain yourself today. You're looking like an orange Navi, I think is a good way of putting it. What are you wearing?
Well, I'm actually wearing, like, some type of... It's just Indian-ish. I just drew this little thing together because I could not find any good cowboy or Indian-type setup.
Sure. Well, you know what? You make a good point there, and like I showed myself, you know what? Not everybody does have the right styles to fit the theme that we've got going. But the important thing is, of course, is that you make the effort. And I can see you've got a... Well, you've got some bows on your back there. So, look, I'm assuming you're an Indian today, are you?
Very.
There you go. And of course, folks, we're talking about the pop culture version of cowboys and Indians, because you know what? It doesn't get more pop culture than being in a superhero game. So no real world comes into it today. We're just talking about good old childhood cowboys and Indians. All right, so let's see. We've got Oro Child there as well. Hi, Oro Child. You're looking really cool. That's a Do you know what? We don't see many outfits that are... Well, that's kind of a brown color. Really like that. Good to see you. Thank you for making the effort. I've got American General in the background there. You know, it's very hard for me to move around because I get pinned in by all of our mighty superheroes. Action Team Joe, g'day to you. Captain America X. And hang on, now Fair, we were talking to you on voice chat before, but I'm stuck in here. I can't actually move. Can you believe it? Whereabouts are you? Oh, I can see you in the background there. Do you want to try and come over to me? Oh, no, there we go. I got out.
I'll try.
I escaped. It's okay. Everything is fine. There we go. Look at this. Fair Blitz. All right. Now, you've got a cape. Oh, goodness gracious me. You're glowing left, right, and center. Hello, Fair. Now, for a start, I didn't recognize you because you don't have your dice out. What's going on there? Did you lose? All right. That was a bit stupid. I shouldn't have mentioned anything, should I? There goes the D20 that is, of course, is synonymous with Fair Blitz. Now, you need to explain yourself. Tell us about your outfit. Firstly, are you a cowboy or are you an Indian? Or are you a blend of both?
Well, I was a cowboy earlier, but I decided to go Indian instead to balance it out, since we seem to have a lot more cowboys.
Yeah, definitely had more cowboys today. All right, so if anyone wanted to know what that is that you're wearing, is it a particular set, or is it a mix and match of a whole bunch of different styles?
A lot of it is the Archangel style.
Archangel?
The Archangel style, which is the basic PvP set, which you can get for free. Well, not free, only money.
Right, of course. There you go. So PvP. Now, you know, I don't play much PvP, as was witnessed in one of our more recent streams, I think, where we... In fact, wasn't it the last stream, Fair, that we did the Legends Arenas? Is that right? I think it was. Pretty sure we were in...
I think so.
Yeah, it was Legends, wasn't it? And in fact, Fair Blitz, I know for a fact that you do quite a bit of PvP, don't you?
Yep.
Yep, so I was very happy to have you on the team. As you found out, unfortunately, I don't. I don't do much at all. So I very much doubt I have any of these styles. But in terms of PvP, are there a lot of PvP-specific sets that you can only get through PvP?
Yeah, there are 5 sets, I think.
5 of them. All right, very, very cool. And I guess, like, is that bought with marks that you get? Like, are they all with the actual currency from PvP, or can you just drop down hard cash on it?
Most of them are bought with marks.
Yeah.
Only right. The first set is bought with cash.
All right, and Kazin, if anyone's watching and they're thinking to themselves, what on earth is a mark? Is that some guy that's hanging around? Do we go and say hello to Mark? What is a PvP mark? What am I talking about, Kazin?
It's a currency.
Right, and how do you get it?
By winning or participating in PvP events.
Oh, hang on. Missions. So by winning PvP, what are the odds of me having tons and tons of PvP marks then? Slim?
Slim and none.
Slim and none? Did you hear that, guys?
On this character, at least.
Well, absolutely. And in fact, look at that. Look, Star, tell us, seeing as you showed us how to do the styles, if I wanted to find out how many marks of whatever... In fact, there you go. There's your first question. What sort of marks are we looking for? What are they called in PvP? And where do I go to find out if I've got any?
Marks of tactics and marks of strategy.
Right. So how do I find them? In the UI.
Inventory.
Hit I to go to your inventory.
Yep.
Then click on currency.
Oh, there we go. Look at that. Items, stats, and currency tab. Okay, here is my... This is what I've got. So let me know if any of these are PvP. I've got replay badges. I've got mark of triumph. I've got mark of distinction. I've got mark of krypton. And I've got... Wow, I've got holly leaves. Can you believe it? Probably from last year's Christmas event. So I'm taking that none of those are PvP marks, yeah?
No, I don't think you've run any PvP on Dfinity. I think it's mostly been Jordan.
Aha! Uh-huh. There you go. That's the excuse, folks. Do you believe me in the chat room? Otherwise, I would have hundreds of thousands of them because I am so good at PvP. Okay, I'm lying. I'm terrible at PvP. Right, Chulma?
Hey, an old friend came back from the Super Bowl.
Yeah, yep, change that subject.
You're
immediately.
Awesome, Sambo.
Thank you, thank you. Who's, is that Lefebvre Verte I could hear? In fact, look at, where are you? I'm trying to find either an all green or an all black character, and unless I'm totally blind, I can't see you here. Who are you on today?
Look for black and gold.
Black and gold.
He was like right behind you.
Oh, really? Wait a minute.
I'm on cauliflower.
Cauliflower?
Right next to me here.
Hang on. Let's have a look around. Here we go. Oh, there we go. All right, there is... No, that's not you. That's not... Oh, there you are. Cauliflower. Okay. I get it.
Cauliflower, who is Indian and doesn't understand all these other people who say they're Indian.
Oh, now why is that? Is it a language barrier?
Perhaps.
Perhaps.
He's from India.
Oh, so we've got a different type of India. Well, there you go. You know what? Cowboys and Indians, I guess
South
we didn't
Asian,
specify.
Sorry.
There you go. Now, you are, let's see, you've got an awesome looking outfit. You know what? Your outfits are always very striking, and they're always sort of singular in color. But remind us again, where did you get those awesome wings from?
Those are the light Sheeta wings, which you can buy in the marketplace.
Or
members can get them for free unless that promotion is over now. I don't know which.
Right, but hang on a minute. Let's rewind here. When you say buy in the marketplace, and we get this question a lot in the comments on our series. Maybe you can help me here. What is the marketplace? An online website. Can I get to it in the game? How does that work? Maybe you can walk us through how to get to it. So, firstly, what is the marketplace?
Lefebvre? It is a place where you can buy stuff for station cash.
Oh, now this is the infamous station cash. So, I'm guessing that that's kind of a currency that you can buy with real-world money, right?
Yes, although if you're legendary, you get a certain amount of it regularly.
That's right.
If you're ongoing legendary.
Yes, and I pay a sub, so I'm legendary, and I get station cash rolling in automatically as a thank you from SOE for me paying a sub. So, okay, if I wanted to check out how much station cash I have or look at the marketplace, Lefebvre, how would I do that? What's the easiest way to get there?
First, you hit escape.
All right, let's do that. Here we go, escape. All right, now, you know what? It's come up with all the options and stuff. I don't want to quit the game or anything. Are you sure about this?
Yeah, I am sure. Way over to the right among the options, you'll see something that looks like a supermarket shopping cart.
Oh, I can see it. Oh, and I hover over it and it says Marketplace. So do I just click on that?
Yes, you do.
All right, here we go. Clicking on the mark. Do you want to launch the marketplace? Hang on. Is this going to chuck me out to a website or something? Is it going to quit the game?
No. Okay. You'll still be in the game.
All right.
You'll just be like taking a pause from the game while you go to the marketplace.
All right. Well, we don't mind doing that just to check it out. Now, it's taking its time. Does it normally take a while to come? Oh, there we go. Unable to start the marketplace. Oh, I guess is the store
what?
Offline or something at the moment? Yeah, there we go. Error, unable to
start.
I'm
looking at it right now.
Are you?
I never encountered that.
Yeah, I was just in it.
Wow. Okay. Well, Stalin, you see, this is the sort of luck. Not only do you refuse to marry me, but things that work for everybody else don't work for me. It's just the way. I think it's SOE's way of saying, aha, Sambo. Something like that. Getting me
okay,
back.
Okay, Sambo?
Yeah?
Kali would be willing to marry you, except she's, you know, not see, that way.
Yeah, right, I see. Thank you very much, Lafay Verte. Neither am I. Not there's anything wrong with that, but that's okay. Thank you very much. Oh, well, look, maybe we'll check out the market. We'll try the marketplace again a bit later on. Obviously, some kind of weird error because I'm Sambo. That's just the way it works, I think. Now, who else have we got around here before we let everyone know what we're going to be doing today? And I can't wait for this either. I'm really excited about the instance, the event that we've got lined up for you guys. So do not go away. We'll be heading in there very, very shortly. You can see, in fact, we've got our team picked already and we'll be talking to them very, very shortly. So let's see, we've got Star, we've seen you, Star. Oh, sorry, Captain Tight Pants, Malcolm Reynolds. We've got Zazero there. We've got Mizzlepilk, and Mizzlepilk is looking like a tiny little cowboy. Very cool. They're going to join us, I think, in the instance that we're going to go to very, very shortly. Who's that flying gangster? They're not in our league, but welcome and hello. It's always good to see players. Doc's daughter, that's a very cool one with the pink there. Aranthus.
Hello, Sambo.
Oh, who's that? Is that Doc's daughter?
Yes, sir.
All right, let's see if we can position ourselves next to you. All right, so this is pink. Are you doing that deliberately? Because you know how much I love pink. Oh, okay. All right, that's okay then. All right, tell us about your outfit. Because, okay, I know the hat you've got on. Everyone knows this hat. But tell us about the rest. Like, what about the vest you've got on? Because you've got a very Colonel Sanders kind of bow tie and very Western-looking vest. What is that?
The vest is the schoolyard top.
Oh, schoolyard. Yep, I know that one. All right, and let's see. What about your skirt and your boots?
The skirt is metalhead, and the boots are heeled.
Oh, do you know what? I love metalhead. Metalhead was the very, very first sort of set that I went for, and that was on my very first character, which was Blaze Purple. And in fact, I think she still wears metal hair. Well, she does have metal hair as well, I think. That's the metalhead hairstyle. But she still wears all of that gear today, so it's got a bit of a special place in my heart. Looking very cool, aside from the pink, because pink is not my favourite colour, although I can't really talk, can I, Doc's daughter? I mean, I'm kind of a little bit pink myself. But anyway, ignore that fact. Eon X beside you, looking very cool as well. And of course, you can see Mind Blast and everyone who we've already spoken to. Now, is there anyone else here we've missed out? Let's see, we've got Chillia. They're looking pretty cool as well. And who else have we got around here? You know what? Who's that?
That's me. I'm sorry for interrupting, but I was going to say that Misfire, who's been on a long hiatus, has joined us in League Chat.
Oh, Misfire, are you there?
I'm in game.
Yes, I am.
Hey, hello. Of course, you've been away, haven't you?
Yeah, for about 5 months.
Wow, well, look, welcome back. Good to have you back.
Thank you.
So did you miss the game while you were away?
Oh yeah, tons.
Tons? Were you... Now, hang on.
Yeah.
You can be honest. Were you off playing another game, or were you busy in real life and didn't have time for any games?
No, I had a lot of real life issues I had to get sorted out that were more important.
Right. And do you know what? That's a really good message there, because, you know, we hear a lot of folk who sacrifice their real life issues for MMOs, and that is bad. That is bad, folks. So, public service announcement, of course, real life always comes first. And that's one of the things we promote here in the Superzeroes. Life is more important than a game. We love our community. We love the game. We love getting together like this. But real life is a billion times more important than anything you could ever do here. Trust me. So good to hear that, my friend. And welcome back. I'm assuming that you sorted most things out. And if so, that's a great sign. It's great to have you back in the team. All right, so let me see now. I think we had a bit of a competition here. Kazin, let's see if I can find Kazin the Crazy. There he is. All right, so Kazin, do you want to tell me what happened? I think before I logged in today, you guys were holding a bit of a competition to get some spots for our alert run today. Am I right?
Yeah, and probably Mind Blaster is probably the best person to talk to that about.
All right, we will do that. And,
right there, right here beside me.
Right here beside. Right, you know me, I get lost.
Come over here, straight ahead. Behind you.
Even if people are next to me, there we go. Right there. I still lose them. There we go, Mine. Now, before we do that, let's have a look in the chat room there. And yes, I can see a lot of people saying, whereabouts are we? We are in Centennial Park. And in fact, you know what I might do? Stay there, Mind Blaster. I'm going to come right back. But I'm just going to super fly straight up here. And there you go. You can see right over there. This is the Centennial Park sign. So if I zoom out a little bit, there we go. So we're right near the sign, and straight behind the sign, there it is. You can see these two bridges. This is where we are at. And somewhere around here in Centennial Park also is the huge Superman statue. And I can't see it on my screen at the moment, but trust me, it is around. So that's where we are, and we're going to be here for another couple of minutes only, and then we're going to be heading off into our alert, and we'll talk about that in just a minute. So in fact, yeah, tell us about what happened. We had a bit of a competition, I think, to get the people for the slots in our event. Is that right?
Yes, it is. What we did today was another Find Me contest. Today, I used one of my alternate characters, Nyborg Grayson, on the hero side.
Right.
To hide, and he was in the gardens over in Gotham, stealthily sneaking around a rose bush.
Really?
And luckily, it took about a half hour for three slots to be filled up. One of which has already had to leave but has been replaced. So you do have a full group that are at least CR34. I think a couple of them are double that number. So Smallville for you should be a breeze.
Now, did you hear that, folks? That is exactly what we are doing. Mind Blaster, Smallville is it. And thank you very much for holding that competition. And congratulations to everyone who made it in. Although I do notice we've got the mighty D20 himself, Fair. Fair, what's your role going to be in this instance?
I'm going to be tanking this instance for you.
Tanking it, and I don't think the other guys who won the competition are in voice chat, so we'll keep the Mighty Super Zeroes in voice chat while we do this, so you guys can have a good old laugh at how many times I probably die in this. Although, no, you're not allowed to laugh. You have to respect me and not be mean to me, right? Yes, I'm sure you would.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, right. So Uno Chaos and Mizzle Pilk, congratulations to those guys who are Fair Blitz. I think they're, what's that, damage and heals, I think. So it looks like we've got a well-rounded group. Now, I'm going to be doing damage in this, right? Because you don't want me healing, do you, Fair?
Well.
No, yeah, he's trying to...
Would you like me to answer that?
No, I don't want you to answer that, actually, Fair Blitz. Thank you very much. Now, I just see a couple of folk in the YouTube channel. And again, big welcome and hello to everybody that's joining us there in the YouTube live chat room. It's great to have you along. And that's why we do these live events. It's for you guys. Lots and lots of fun. And I can see that somebody says, hey, my PS3 keeps crashing. And I think, who was that? JL Man, yes. So your PS3 keeps crashing, it's annoying. And I think one of the guys said, hey, when it does that, you just need to try and turn it off and on and retry. It took me a while. Who's this? Booyah Sharka is saying, yes, mine did that too. Turn off your PS3, keep retrying, and it will get... Yes, you'll get on eventually. There you go. So there's the answer, hopefully, for that. By the way, you know what, we're on the PC version here, folks, of course, as you can tell. Can I get a show of hands with a yay or a nay from everybody in the chat room? Does anyone here actually play DC Universe Online on their PS3? Yay or nay, guys? Yay.
Nay.
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 Nay, so no, we don't have many folk who play. You know what, I do have a PS3 and I occasionally get on. It's actually a really cool game to play on the couch on your PS3. Now, Lady Solara, are you still there in chat? Can't see you. No, she gone. I think she might have gone. So what about you, Starlin? Were you a yay or a nay on that one?
I was a nay.
Do you actually have a PS3 out of interest?
Actually, no, I don't.
Oh, well, that would be a good reason why you don't play it on the PS3. If you did have a console, do you think you'd enjoy playing this from the comfort of the couch on your nice TV rather than on the computer? Is that something that you would do?
Yeah, if I could actually afford the PS3 right now.
There you go. Well, you know what? They have come down in price a lot from the old days, so I'm happy about that. Now, look at this. EZO119 in the YouTube's chat is saying, I will try not to laugh, Sambo. It will be hard. Oh, that's a bit mean. That's a bit mean. You know what? It's actually completely true. But, yeah, well, do you know what? The reason, I mean, I could go as heels. What do you reckon, Kazin? Should I go in as heels just for the laughs? Or would that be a really bad move? Yeah.
How are you specced?
I'm specced Sambo style. That should tell you everything that you need to know.
Sambo spec is eeny, meeny, miny, moe. I'll pick that one. Yeah. Oh, that one sounds good. That one sounds good.
Well, do you know what? Actually, truth be known, in fact, I'm going to bring up my powers. Here we go. Here's my powers. I'm going to go to summoning, which is what I am. And, oh, no, in fact, do you know what? I'm going to go back a little bit. I'm going to go to skills. When I logged in here this morning, all my skills were reset, right? That's because I haven't been on Dfinity for a while. And I went into weapons, and I went into my dual pistol, because that's what I am. And I thought, oh, how am I going to spec myself? And here's what I did. Click, 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 click. Oh, pretty colors. Click, 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 click. That makes a nice pattern, and I'm done.
Respect yourself.
Yep, so...
Did you remember to get super speed?
Do you know what? You're going to be so proud of me. In fact, I'm going to show you right now. Flight. Look at that. There is one skill point in super speed because I actually remembered. I can't believe
Yay.
It. Yeah, I know.
Yay.
I know, thank you very much. Because all my other characters have to limp around at normal speed because I completely forgot about that. Anyway, I did it, so I'm very happy about that. Well, look, the cat is out of the bag, folks. We are indeed going to be running Smallville for your viewing pleasure. In fact, we're going to get in there very, very shortly. Now, who's the best person that can give me a breakdown of what we're to expect in Smallville? Because obviously, you know where we're going. It's Smallville, just like the series, just like the comics, just like the movies. It's, I think, a farm town, and it's going to look very, very familiar. And obviously, it's got something to do
with... That would be with, me.
That would be you. Okay, Superman. So,
that
but
would
what
be me.
What about the actual... Why are we going in there? I mean, are we going to say hello to Superman's parents? Do we have to go feed the cows?
You are going there to deal with a whole, like, zillion different versions of Doomsday.
Of Doomsday? Dum, dum, dum. Not Doomsday. Hang on a minute.
Yes,
when you say
Doomsday,
different...
with all the spikes and everything.
Oh, so hang on. Do we have different... What do you mean different versions of Doomsday? There is only one Doomsday, surely.
No, there are multiple, and you don't have to call me Shirley.
Relax has been messing with the genetic makeup of Doomsday, trying to create an army, and so there's all different versions.
Oh, you are kidding. Oh, my lord. Okay, hang on a minute. My memory serves me correctly, if it does. Aren't there a whole bunch of superheroes at the end as well that we have to deal with, or am I dreaming?
Yeah, they help you.
Oh, they come and help us. You know what? Maybe that's where I went wrong last time. I was trying to attack them, I think. That's how good I am, folks. That's how good I am at understanding what goes on in these instances. Alright, so if you...
They only come and help you if you are judged sufficiently sincere, just like the Great Pumpkin.
Oh, I see. Well, look, at least, you know, I might be stupid, but I am sincere. I think you'll agree with that one. Do you know what? I've got a question coming in the chat there from JL Man. Big hello to you. Thank you for joining us in our live today. Sambo, what do you think is the best power? Now, you know, I get asked that so many times, and it's a hard one to answer because I love so many of the power sets in this game. But you know what? One that I have a lot of fun on, I must admit, is the hard light set. Because there's nothing like summoning a jet fighter or summoning a behind me there. Star Kestrel, what have you got there? Is that a chainsaw? It is, isn't it?
Yeah, that's one of my primary attacks.
There you go. making one hell of a racket in the background. That is the Hard Light Power, and of course that's only available through the Fight for the Light DLC set that you can buy off the marketplace, or you get it free, of course, if you're a subscriber and you are therefore legendary. Alright, well, I don't know about you, Kazin and Chilma, but I think it's about time we headed into the alert. Now, Kazin, from a normal person's standpoint, now not mine, but a normal person, if you were to group up and take a run of this instance, you know, with just normal people, how long would it take to get through Smallville, just so folks get an idea?
Maybe 30 minutes.
30 minutes or so? All right, so we're looking at probably an hour when it comes to me, right?
Yeah, 45 minutes.
All right, there you go, folks.
Or so that, maybe it, 2 hours.
Maybe 2 hours, we don't know. Well, in fact, you know what, we
are... Maybe three.
Well, this is the thing, folks. I'll just put a little disclaimer up here right now. Of course, we are live streaming. We're about to dive into Smallville and say goodbye to our Super Zeroes, our mighty Super Zeroes out the front here. Of course, they'll still join us in voice chat, so that's okay. But we do have a 2 hour limit on our stream. So we've got an hour and 20 minutes to get through it. So if we don't finish the alert, although Lord help us if we can't get through it in an hour and 20, we will have to cut it short, just letting you know ahead of time. All right, well, I don't know about you, but I am itching to get into Smallville. Fair Blitz, you're the only one in our team who's on voice chat. Are you prepared to enter Smallville and take on Doomsday with, well, me? Are you prepared?
I have my D20. I'm always prepared.
You've got the D20, all right. The D20 saves everything. So, look, we're going to hop in and we're going to queue on that in just a second. But before we do, I'd like to thank everybody in this mighty Super Zeroes who came and joined us here in Centennial Park. It's always great to have a big turnout from the Super Zeroes. And, of course, you know what? In some places in the world, it's a crazy time of the day, so we really do appreciate it. Kazin, you're not coming in with us. I bet you're pretty pleased about that because you pretty much, whenever you run an instance with me, you just spend the whole time cringing, don't you?
No, I don't cringe.
Well, okay.
I got your back, man.
Okay. And you got my back and you laugh as well. You laugh behind it. That's what I think anyway. And of course...
Absolutely.
Maybe a giggle or two.
Right. You know what? I know Kazin is going to be listening along. He won't be able to see what's going on, but he'll be able to tell from what we're talking about, and I'm sure he'll be having a chuckle as I completely mess things up. Chilma, thank you and the team for organizing this week's event. Do you have absolutely any clue what we're going to be doing next in a fortnight's time, or is that a secret?
I will say on the 15th we're going to get ready for our Christmas event, so you should have fun with that.
Oh, you know what? You bring up a big point there. Yes, ho, ho, ho. It is coming up Christmas time, so we are absolutely going to have a Christmas event. Don't you worry about that, and I hope that all of you guys can join us. Now, I've got a message there saying, hey, we missed a few people. Look, I know it's always hard. We always miss out on a few folk. We always try to get as many people in the video as possible, but unfortunately, we're always on a bit of a hard time limit, so hopefully over the course of our series, we get to say hello to everybody, but my apologies for that. There we go. There's the mighty Super Zeroes right there. All right, well, I don't know about you guys, but I think it's time to say goodbye to the Super Zeroes in game here. And again, we'll keep them on voice chat. Oh, look at this. Who's this? Love Princess Aura. Hello to you in the voice chat. Sambo, one tip. Oh, hey, Kazin, we're getting a tip coming in. This is good news. One tip is the Soul Wells. The Soul Wells are your friends. Do you have it on? Oh, okay, so help me out here. What is he talking about, Kazin? What's a soul well, and what's it got to do with me?
I'm not sure. What is your power?
I am... Let's have a look. I'm going to open up my power set here. I am powers... Let's see. I'm summoning and destiny. So I'm guessing...
Sorcery. Yeah, so soul wells is a power that helps you. Are you going to be healing?
No, so I won't be using that, will I?
But you can still use it for damage.
Oh, okay. But no, I don't think it's something I've got on my hotbar. In fact, hang on. Let's go into my power set. We'll open up K, and we'll go to my loadout. And we'll go to damage. There we go. So I have got Summon My Fury. It's my little pet. I've got a Boon of Souls. I've got... Oh, I have got Soulwell. Yes, I have. Conjure a Soulwell to damage nearby enemies, depending on your role. You'll either heal them or improve their offense. Oh, allies. Oh, this is good for you guys, Fair Blitz. So I'm going to be able to actually improve your offense every time you knock out an enemy. That's pretty cool. We've got Wrath here, which blasts an enemy with magical energy. I've got Transmutation, which unleashes a magical force to damage enemies and explode nearby. You know, I love explosions, so I'm all for that one. And I've got Soul Storm, which is, I love this one. Blasts a barrage of magical projectiles to knock down and damage enemies. So very, very, very cool. And no, I can't, JL Man in the chat is saying use your PowerPoints. Well, I've got nothing to actually use them on. And I mean, not for this anyway, because I've got all the powers that I need. I've got the ones in my hotbar that I like. I've actually spent all of them. If we go back into the K menu here, I've got all of my skills and my weapon. They're all done. There you go. They're all turned on. So there's nothing I can actually spend them on right now that's going to be an advantage to us in this particular episode. And in fact, let me see. Let's go to Star Saber. I get that question a lot. What do you do with all the extra power points that you have? Do you spend them in different weapon types? Is there any benefit to it?
You mean skill points or
yes,
power points?
Well, either. But especially I'm looking at the, the skill points in my weapon tree. My dual pistol is already maxed out, so why would I want to spend more skill points in there? I can't.
Well, what I do is I go into each weapon tree has it one innate skill for each role that you can put up to 3 points into.
Oh.
So I'd go through and I can equip any of the weapons. I don't have all the combos for them, but I have at least the DPS innate skills for them.
Right, so this is one thing, this is why we have this list here. So if I wanted to, even though Dfinity is a dual pistol, I could click on bow and start putting like access to the bow. I could put a point in there, and that means Dfinity could actually start wielding bows, right?
Yeah, I mean, I'm mainly hand blasters, but I grabbed dual pistols so I'd have revolvers for my costume.
Right. Of course, that makes total sense. All right, thank you very much. And by the way, can I just say behind us there and beside us, Magic Fear and Captain America X, both looking fantastic. Jeez, some of these folk, just their skill with the costume creator is unbelievable. Like, compared to me, I struggle. That's why I keep my costumes the same, because I'm hopeless at it. Eon EX is looking very cool as a robot there. Who can tell me? Kazin, I don't know if you can see Eon EX, who's right in front of me here. They look like a robot. Is that a costume, or is that a shape-shifting tonic or something?
I'm not sure.
It's a shape-shifter.
It looks like one of the marketplace ones.
Yeah, very cool. Very cool. Oh, look at that American General flying in the background there with those amazing wings. That looks so cool. Jeez, you know what? You guys are incredible. And of course, that's why we love DC Universe Online, because honestly, no two people look the same. They really, really don't. In fact, I can see Misfire. I'm just going to hop over to... No, I'm stuck here, I think. Can I get out of here? There we go. Go up to see Misfire, if I can stop myself from hitting on the bridge. Where are they? There we go. They're looking very... Misfire, you're still in chat, aren't you, I think?
Yes.
Yes. You didn't have... Did you have wings on before? You've changed up your costume, haven't you?
At first I wanted to have wings, but I misclicked on when I was doing my costume, and then I put them back on.
Alright. But that's one of the great things about DCUO, is that you don't have to create a new character to change your outfit. You can actually do it on the fly, which is one of the greatest things. Look at that, Captain Hawk Frost. That is an awesome outfit there with the Superman logo on the front, the amazing wings. You know what, I've got a long way to go to get gear like that. Alright, well, I do think it's time. Fair Blitz, are you ready? Should we head on into Smallville? I think we're about ready.
Yes, let's do that.
Alright, so I think it's time definitely to say goodbye to the mighty Superzeroes in the background there. So let's give them a hearty salute. That is for the mightiness that is the Superzeroes. And again, thanks to all of you guys for turning up in-game here in Centennial Park. And if you're watching along live on the chat, if you were to come to Centennial Park right now, if you play DC Universe Online, you'll be able to meet up with all of these guys. They are here right now. And who knows, maybe some of you guys will be able to do some instances and missions with the mighty Superzeroes themselves. I'm sure they'd be into that. So, I don't know, I think, no, we're not going to say goodbye to the chat room because they're going to join us behind the scenes in Smallville and they can laugh along at my miserable failures. Look at that, good luck is coming in from the chat room. Thank you, these guys are going to need it because they've got me on their team. All right, so Fairblitz, walk me through this. How do we get ourselves into a queue for the Smallville alert? Because it's not a normal alert, it's, I think it's a tier 1 alert, which means it's a little bit harder than the usual thing. How do we do that, Fair?
It's the usual method, really. We'll press Y to go to our on-duty menu.
Y, hang on. All right, here we go. We've got Y. Now I've got 1 player, 2 player, 4 player, 8 player. Where do I need to be looking?
We want 4 player.
4 player, okay. Now I've got a problem. I can only see Area 51, Gorilla Island, Hive Moon Base, Oolong Island, and Blood... Oh, there's more down below. So Tier 1... Okay, Fair, tell us, what's the difference between General, Tier 1, and Tier 2? Why would I want to run Tier 1 of something rather than a General one?
Basically just the difficulty, the sort of things that drop.
You mean the fat loots? The fat loots are better?
Basically, yeah.
Okay, so how come there's an Area 51 in general, and there's an Area 51 in Tier 1, but I'm looking at Smallville here, and it's only in Tier 1? How come there's no general one?
Because with Area 51, there's the general alert, which we've done many, many times before.
We have.
And then there's the harder one, which will be harder, and you require better gear to get into it, and it'll drop better stuff.
Okay,
all right. Has
but there's no easier one for Smallville.
It.
Right, now what was that, Lafay Verte? Is there differences apart from the gear and the difficulty level? Is there any content difference?
Yes, the higher level Area 51 has some interesting enemies that aren't there in the regular one.
There you go. Alright, so if you guys are wondering, if you're watching along from home, why do a harder one? That's why. It's, yes, difficult. It's much more difficult, so more of a challenge, but you're going to get fatter loot, and you're going to have different content. So there you go. Alright, so if I click on Smallville, let's have a read of this. Lex Luthor's horrific experiments with Doomsday's DNA have turned the peaceful town of Smallville into a disaster area. Even the LexCorp scientists have been affected. Uh-oh. Only the Justice League, or the Mighty Superzeroes League, can stop this menace before it spreads. All right, so that's exactly as the guys...
Or the villains.
Yeah, or the villains. That's right. Of course, you can run this
they
on...
They can, too.
...on either side. Yep, very good point. All right, so... Now, Fair, I'm staring at a window here, and it says Smallville. It's got a little checkbox beside it, so I presume I click that, right?
Yep.
There we go. All right, now it's just got a big Q button. Can I click on Q without breaking the game?
Yes, you can.
All right, and hi, Jai, in the chat. Sorry, I'm late. It's okay. It's perfect timing. We're about to head into Smallville, so good timing for you. Look at this. Cademon's Cal 99 in the YouTube chat is saying, I don't know if I should feel sorry for Smallville or relieved that they are going to get help. I think they should fear because I'm coming and I'm not very good at this. So here we go. All right, I'm going to click on the Q button. And now, okay, now this confuses a lot of people, Fairblitz. I've got a thing down the bottom that says my status and ready, but I can't click on ready. It won't let me click on it. So what's going on there?
You need to select what role you're going to be in the instance.
Okay, so where's my select role button? I don't see one.
Just below it.
Oh, where it says no role selected? So I click on that. There we go. All right, okay. So you can see I've got a couple that are unavailable to my power type, but I've got healer. The healer role is to heal your team and keep them fighting by replenishing their health. I could play that. Could go a healer, although I think everyone would get very nervous if I was a healer. And then we've got damage, and that's what I'm going to do. Damage role, of course, is to eliminate all enemies as quickly and efficiently as possible. All power types can fill a damage role. Okay, let's check that. And select, there we go. All right, now can I click on ready, Fair Blitz?
Yep.
All right, here we go. I'm going to click on ready. And thank you. Look at that. All the good luck pouring in. You can enter your Smallville alert instance now. Kazin, do you think Smallville is ready for the awesomeness that is my skill? Do you think they're ready for me? Can they handle it?
They're ready. They're ready.
Oh, okay. All right. So, okay, fine. Here we go, folks. Wish us luck. I'm going to click on OK. And hopefully in a few seconds, that means we're going to get transported to the beginning of a Smallville. Now, just Fair and everyone else in the voice chat, I'll let you know if there's a cutscene. If we cannot talk during the cutscenes, that would be great because that means our viewers watching along from home get to hear any that are coming up in the game. And of course, we love all of that. No doubt we're probably going to hear from Lex Luthor. Here we go. We're loading in. And will we get... Here we go.
This small town is Smallville. We've discovered Lex is attempting to develop a new weapon against Brainiac. He's iterating on exobyte technology, using Doomsday as his muse. These people are test subjects for Lex's new strain. With your prior exobyte exposure, you are immune. But we need to know more in order to reverse the effects on these citizens. Calm the situation here and get to the Lex Core analysis units.
All right, so it was Martian Manhunter who was giving us a briefing. And Fair Blitz, you've already found us a shiny. Thank you.
Yes, I have.
Let's help grab yourself. It. Thank you very, very much. Let's grab this. And it looks like a collection. All right, so now where are the rest of our team? There we go. There's Mizzle Pilk. Big hello to you. And there is Uno Chaos as well. Let's give them a wave. All right, so Fair Blitz, I'm looking around here. And where are we? I mean, it looks to me like we are on the outskirts. I mean, I'm just going to fly up for a second and head over here. I know this is not the way we want to go. But it's very well done, isn't it? I mean, this does look like a rural little town in the middle of farmland. Is that where we're meant to be?
Pretty much.
And we'll just greet on that.
Yeah, we're just on the outskirts of Smallville.
Okay, so you can see we've got the power posts there, and you can see, look at that. I can see a barn off in the distance there. Very, very well done. Of course, we love the way that the instances are done in DC Universe Online. They capture the atmosphere absolutely perfectly. Okay, so Fair Blitz, I can see that I've got an objective down here, and it says protect the LexCore exabyte data scan. So do I need to speak to this person first? I guess I can try.
This is just a vendor, so you might have to repair your stuff if you can.
Yeah, definitely want to repair. Let's do that. Repairs, repair all, because I'm not going to go in broken. There we go, all done. All right, so protect the LexCore exabyte data scan. So I guess, look, everyone's leapt ahead here. Do we just start beating up on these guys?
For the moment. You'll see over here we've got this red doom thing with things around that we can break.
Yes.
Once we break it, we'll have to protect what's inside from some larger mobs that will appear.
Okay. Can I get this? Oh, hang on. Here's Martian Manhunter.
Units, don't destroy them. They contain vital data on the experiment. If you can get through their shields and redirect their data to the watchtower, we can develop a plan to help Luthor's victims.
All right, you heard him now. I am going to grab a shiny. I know it's bad timing, but I must get all shinies. Oh, here's Superman.
This is not easy for me to say, but I am counting on you to save Smallville. Unlike you, I have no exabyte-given protection, and we can't risk spreading Doomsday's DNA. I know you'll put Luthor's plan down, and trust me, he'll pay for what he's doing here.
Thank you, Superman. All right, so we are now protecting this. Is this a data scan, is it, Fair Blitz? And we're protecting it from these...
Yes, it is.
Right, so waves of enemies that are coming in, and we're doing a very good job. How do we know when we've finished this one? Will the counter go up and say one of three, I'm assuming?
It will, yeah. There's no way of knowing how far through we are on this current one. But the main mobs we have to protect them from are those larger ones, like you saw the Doom Craze Guard that we saw just then.
Yes, this one here.
Those are the only ones that are capable of breaking it. So if one of those gets to it, then we'll have to restart.
Oh, okay, so we definitely want to take down the Doom-crazed guards first. Not a problem. Oh, and what's happening here? I've for some reason got stuck there. That's weird. All right, so, oh, hang on. So it's still saying 0 out of 3. Do we really want to leave the vicinity of this one? We don't, do we? No, not yet.
Nope, not yet.
All right, so we just have to wait. Now, do the other ones have a countdown timer or something so we know what's going on?
Basically, yeah. We just have to do three of these things, which are in different locations.
Right, okay. Alright, there we go. 1 out of 3. So let's make our way further into this map. And there it is. There's the second data scan there. The exabyte data scan you can see up ahead. And we're going to take out these Doom-fused citizens. So, Kazin, I know you can't see what we're doing here, although you've probably run this enough times so you know where we are. How did these... I mean, these citizens here look a bit like Doomsday. What's happened?
DNA, that corp has been messing with Doomsday's DNA. Try to create the Doomsday monster, and this is the result of experiment gone bad.
Oh, okay. So you know what? Just like most movies, genetic experimentation should be a sign of bad things to come. All right, let's have a look in the loot window here, and we got boots of the lower. We'll greed on those, and look at that, some nice biomesh boots as well. They're definitely always going to greed, just in case anyone else here in the run can do with them. Although I'd imagine that, Fair Blitz, your CR is through the roof compared to mine, so you're not going to be wanting any of this gear, are you?
No, I don't need any of this.
No. There we go, some more loots. Now, for those of you who are asking what is my CR, we'll check that in just 1 second. There we go, let's go into the inventory and go to my stats, and you can see that my combat rating is 41. So there you go. And who's that? James Dog in the chat. Just going to quickly go to the chat room, so hopefully I don't die in game. Say hi to Jonathan and Martha Kent for me, Sambo, says James Dog. We will. Good luck in Smallville, says Lady Solara. Now, did Lady leave us in chat? I think Star Saber, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here.
Did you see if Lady is Lady in chat? Did she have to leave?
She left chat about half an hour ago.
Oh dear. Well, Lady, thank you for your good luck. And I think, I can't remember, who was it that ran this with us? Oh no, it wasn't Lady, it was Wicked. Wicked Love, I think, came in here in one of our only filmed League events in here, the only other time we've been in here. Alright.
Yep.
So that's it, two out of three. Yep, great. Alright, so I'm following you guys. I, of course, have no clue where we need to go. I guess we follow these Doom-crazed citizens with my dual pistols. I love this power set. Do love me some pistols. This is my John Woo move. We haven't seen, of course, we don't really do the Let's Play for Dfinity these days much anymore because she is already level 30, but I do miss playing on her very, very much. Now, EZO119 in the chat room is saying, my favorite DC character is Manhunter, but Sambo is better. Oh dear. You know what? Once you come out of your weird delusion, you'll realize that that's not true. I am not better. Dear, oh dear, oh dear. Once you've watched this live stream, you will definitely want to re-evaluate your statement there, I'm afraid. Good luck. Yes, thank you very much, everybody. We're definitely... You know what? We do need luck. We always need luck. But I am surrounded here by fantastic players. You can see that. They are definitely... Well, they know what they're doing, unlike me. And, of course, that's going to make me look good. Now, I've just put a shield up on everybody, so hopefully that helps. And, of course, I did that right at the end of the wave when nobody needed it. So you are welcome. No problem there, Fair. I hope that was handy for you.
Every little helps.
Every little bit helps. Okay, here's one of these guards. We definitely want to take him down. Were they the ones that were going to actually... Oh, there's another one. That destroy the exabyte data scan, right? Is that right?
Yeah. If they manage to reach here, they'll attack it and we'll have to restart this one.
Okay. Now, I can see... Just looking in chat while we wait for this to tick over. Starlin, I can see you're in chat. Now, Star, you don't join us here in the instance, but have you run this instance before, Star, the Smallville alert?
No, I haven't.
Oh, you haven't? Oh, okay. You know what? You really need to, because it's super fun so far. Well, you know what? Ask me that a little bit later on, because I'm sure when I'm getting my rear handed to me on a plate, I'll be crying and it won't be fun. But so far, it's definitely lots of fun. So is there a reason for that? Is that because your CR isn't high enough? Oh, hang on a second. What's this? A doom-crazed giant. Ah! You know what? That didn't look good. Star, is that because you don't have the right combat rating, or you just haven't got around to coming in here?
Just haven't gotten around to coming in.
Yeah, look, I can highly recommend it, because right now we are fighting a doom-crazed giant. This looks like it's our first mini-boss Fair Blitz. Is there anything we need to know about this fight?
Not really. It's basically just your general tank and spank.
Tank and spank, alright, I can handle that, no problem at all. Ooh, although he knocks his back
tornadoes.
A lot.
Oh yeah, he does create a couple of tornadoes that will harm you a lot if you get hit by them.
Okay, so...
Get up on the hillside.
Oh, thank you very much for that. So we avoid them like the plague then?
It's usually a good idea to go up the side of the hill, that way you stay out of those tornadoes.
Alright, we'll have a listen to Martian Manhunter.
When the Lex Cortex became infected themselves, try to get genetic samples to build our data. LexCorp was testing the clones against Brainiac weaponry. Perhaps that will give you an edge.
Thank you, Martian Manhunter. Just quickly going to our YouTube's chat, Dylan Z Token, it will be fun for us if you cry. Thank you very much for that. Super Fluffy Sage is saying, Sambo rocks, and Philip L. Moti is, you remind me of Superman, but with two pistols, and I don't know why. You know what, you're not the only person to say that, so I'm not sure what that is. Anyway, let's have a look at the fat loots first, and we've got ourselves a Mighty Reaper's Scythe, so good luck in that one. Now, Fair Blitz, I don't know, that went pretty well for our first boss fight. What do you reckon? Are we going to be okay later on based on that fight there, or are we in trouble for
later on? Yeah, I think we should be fine.
Should be fine?
Yeah, we should be fine.
There we go. All right. And again, my thanks to Uno Chaos and Mizzle Pilk, who are doing a great job here along with Fair Blitz. Okay, so Fair, I can see if I look at my quest tracker here, collect Brainiac Bottling Nanotech from Base Camp Alpha. I have no idea where we need to go, so I'm going to step back behind everyone here and follow you guys. So lead the way, please, Fair Blitz. We go to Base Camp Alpha. I have no idea where we're going to go. All right, so I'm guessing, though, that we're in the city area, and it looks like it's been hit pretty hard, Fair Blitz. Look at that sunset, by the way. That looks amazing. Are we going to be heading out into the rural areas anytime soon? Or oh, no, here we are now. Okay, so what's this area here, please, Fair?
We just have a little objective here where we have to find some certain stronger mobs and sort of encase them in shields and then carry them back to here.
Okay, so this is a... I remember this. So we have to actually pick them up and then we get the big arrow over our heads and take them back to that little base camp there. Would that be right?
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Now,
and if you look over here, Uno Chaos has already got one over there.
Oh! Okay, let's hop over there. Oh, I'm grounded. Now, I remember this. Now, you might be saying to yourself, how come Chaos is walking so slowly? It's because, yes, when you pick this up, you do get a debuff which forces you to walk, and then you get attacked by all of these citizens, and you've got to try and get it back to base. It is quite a hard task, actually. So if I hit E on this, what happens? There we go, and if I pick it up, alright, so this is me, I've got it now, and I'm going to try and walk back over here. And hopefully the folks can try and keep these other enemies off my back. Am I doing the right thing, Fair Blitz?
Yep, just about. Just hit get one on the pad.
And there we go! Alright! Can you believe it, folks? It was me that got the first one. I'm sure that won't ever happen ever again. And you know what? I think the guys are letting me feel like I know what I'm doing. So thanks for that. And there we go. A Soul Storm is out. Now, while we collect the other four of these, I do want to go and grab my shiny because I'll forget it otherwise. And if you're watching along from home, do not do this. You do not collect shinies in the middle of the fight. Do not take my actions as the norm. All right, so Fair Blitz, this looks like it could be quite rough. I mean, you know, we have to collect those things, and you're very vulnerable when you're bringing them back to the base camp, aren't you? I mean, you're walking, is there anything else? Do you get any other debuffs?
No, you just get very slow, basically, and it's up to me and the others to keep them off you.
Right, okay. Now let us know if anyone else picks one up, because I will try and come to do exactly the same thing. But what mobs are we looking for? Is it those big tall ones, isn't it?
If you look on the map, you'll see a few yellow arrows.
Oh.
And those are locations of the other mobs.
Okay, alright, well, why don't you pick one and lead the way, and we'll head on out there rather than fighting these guys.
So we're gonna I think we should go to this top left one over here.
Okay.
We just have to pass over this hill.
Right. Oh my god, I found a blue shiny! Hang on! Oh, must get shiny! Must get shiny! There we go.
This is Lois Lane for Daily Planet Live. Residents of Metropolis may recall the horror of Doomsday's arrival on Earth to murder Earth's greatest hero, Superman. Now reports indicate that versions of Doomsday have been unleashed in the quiet town of Smallville, Kansas.
All right, go for it, Uno Chaos. Now, by the way, thanks for showing us how to find the other ones. They are, well, in fact, they're covered up by our overlay, our Mumble Chat overlay, but you can maybe see on my mini-map just behind the overlay, we have... Ow! They're throwing rocks at us. There are a bunch of yellow arrows. That is what Fair Blitz was talking about. And if you follow them... Oh, there we go. Uno Chaos has got it again. If you follow them, you will find the mobs that you're looking for, which are these guys here. And in fact, yes, if you have a look on your map as well, you can see these the exclamation marks, Fair Blitz. Are they where the other ones are as well on the map?
Yeah, that's the one.
Alright, there we go. Alright, well done. Well done, team. That is 2 out of 5. Alright, look, I'm going to lead the way to the next one. Off into the sunset, which is the one to the top right over here. Is it this? Is it this doom-formed citizen? Is that what we want?
Yep.
Alright, let's see if we can take him down. Will you look at those graphics, folks? Look at the sunset in the background there as we take down this doom-formed citizen. There we go. Can now hit the use button to pick this guy up, I hope, and there we go. Alright, now hopefully the team will keep these guys off my back as I very slowly try and avoid these doom-crazed citizens here and make our way back to base camp and deliver one of these. And of course, this is going to be 3 out of 5.
And he's broken out.
Oh, he's broken out. All right. So I'm guessing that they break out on their own as well as being attacked by their mates. Would that be right?
Yeah. It's set on a timer.
Ah, okay. There we go. Thank you, guys. All right. Let's see if we can do it. See if we can make it back by the end of the next time. Oh, and in fact, the timer... I think the timer is actually over the base there, we can see. There we are. All right, so of course, you're always following the green arrow. Now, I cannot fly. I can't do anything. I just have to very slowly make my way in. And, oh, look at that. He broke out again. Didn't quite make it there. And there we go. Fair Blitz. Take it home, my friend. Take it home. And there we are, 3 out of 5. Let's go to the other top one here to the northeast. And you guys, look at this. You're in for a treat. You get that beautiful view of Smallville in the background there. That is absolutely amazing. And in fact, I don't know about you, Fair Blitz, but I reckon they nailed the look and feel of this zone. It is very much like the TV series and the movie, wouldn't you say?
I think so. I haven't actually seen the TV series yet.
Right.
Something I need to do at some point.
You do. Oh boy, alright, so let's see, we'll go back to Star Saber, who's with us in voice chat. Hopefully you're listening along and you can hear our progress. What's your synopsis so far of our performance? I mean, you must have run this many, many times in the past. Is it pretty atypical of what goes on in here, or is it a lot worse than awful, than normal?
Seems like it's going pretty smooth so far, and yeah, I have run it plenty of times, including with you.
Yep, that's right, you have indeed, and you remember what a nightmare that was. Hopefully I'm doing better this time, do you think, by the sound of things?
Well, actually, we did pretty well last time, too.
Well, yeah, we did, to be honest, and that's, of course, because I always surround myself by great players. That's my trick. Now, what about you, Kazin? beforehand.
He went back to the Mumble server.
Oh, is he gone? Oh, what about you, Chulma? I mean, you know, I'm not sure if you had much confidence in me going in here, but based on what you're hearing, what about you? And do you run this very often?
I don't really run Smallville a lot, but I'm also watching the live stream in a way. So far, you're good. You guys are doing pretty good.
All right.
And I never had any doubt in you. I always had confidence in you.
Thank you, Chulma. You're on my Christmas card list. Never any doubt. Oh, I'm getting buses thrown at me. Dear, oh dear.
That's why this is one of my favorite parts of the incident. You can throw buses at things.
Yeah. Of course, the mighty D20 and a bus. It's a perfect combination. Now, can I get around here? There we go. Can I take it home? There we go. And that is 4 out of 5. All right, we're doing very well. We got one more of these to go. Now, let's have a look in chat. Who can I see in there who we haven't spoken to for a while? Dr. Sun. Dr. Sun, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Oh, now you're very, very quiet. So I'm
sorry.
Yes, that's okay. Sir. There you are. Now, tell us, you're listening along to this perhaps. Have you run this instance before for a start?
No, I haven't.
Oh, you haven't? All right, so this is probably sounding a little bit foreign to you. Now, what's the reason that you haven't been in here? Is it your combat rating, or it's just not something that you have got around to yet?
It's just something I haven't gotten around to yet.
Okay, I can highly recommend it, because are you a Superman fan? Have you watched Smallville, or have you watched any of the movies of Superman?
Yes, I've seen every for the most recent.
Well, there you go. All right. So would you call yourself a bit of a, well, maybe not a fan, but you like Superman?
Yes, I do.
All right, then, you know what? I can highly recommend that you come in here because you're going to see a whole bunch of familiar sights and sounds, including Superman himself. We've already heard from him in here. And the guys and gals at SOE do such a great job of capturing the atmosphere. So I do highly recommend it. All right, who else have we got in chat there? Miss Fire with her brown wings. We remember her from out on the bridge. What about you? Have you played this particular instance before?
A long time ago.
A long time ago. Now, is there any reason why you haven't been in here recently?
By the time I got back into playing, the T4 alert has been around, so I've been busy doing that.
Okay, so it's you're driven by the fat loots. Is that a fair comment?
Yeah.
I understand that, and there's nothing wrong with that. Alright, well, fair. I mean, looks to me like this is the last. Yep, this is the last of them, isn't it? This will make it 5 out of 5, is that right?
Yep, and once you put that in, we'll have an. I think we have to use a console, and that'll summon the next mini boss.
Oh dear, good lord, okay. Now, just before I. Oh, there we go, no, there we are. Alright, start the DNA sample transfer process. So, here's the console here. Now, how many bosses actually are there, Fair Blitz? Like, once we've actually activated this one, you know, how far through are we?
So we've done that first one. This is the second one. Then we've got two more. Well, one more boss. Then we're doing there's Doomsday.
Oh my lord! All right, so let's get on with it, folks. Here we are activating the Oh, here we are, Lady Doombringer. Okay, so we have to defeat Lady Doombringer, and oh my lord, she's huge. And yes, Jai is saying, hey, can I please get a shout out for Granny Jai, as it's her birthday today. Whoa, okay, that is very cool. I don't know, but anyone in the chat room, what do you reckon? I think we could have a massive big happy birthday to Granny Jai. What do you reckon? Hooray, happy birthday, Granny Jai. What do you think, Fair?
Hip, hip, yep, hooray. Definitely. Happy birthday.
Absolutely.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. There you go, Granny Jai. Now, we'll be polite, and we won't ask how old she is, but well done. All right, so there we go. Look at that. Lady is down, and here is Martian Manhunter.
On the Doomsday DNA, cut off their feed to LexCorp's main source, and the effects fail within moments. We need you to test this at the farmhouse where LexCorp has started administering the DNA. Destroy LexCorp's equipment and save anyone still inside.
Now, Fair Blitz, I'm not sure if you're aware of this, but... Oh, no, nothing. I was just going to say something happened to you. Something very strange happened to you there, but everything is okay now. Now, before we loot the fat loots here, who can tell me what that was? That looked like Miss Pac-Man was next to you, Fair. What on earth was that?
That was Miss Boo.
Miss Boo!
One of the trinkets you could get from the recent Halloween event.
That's right. So it obviously lasts all year round, even though it's only available in Halloween. You can use it at any time, is that right?
Yep.
Alright, fantastic. Alright, let's have a look at the fat loots, folks. And it requires the role of a controller, so I'm going to pass on that one. Alright, now you can see we've got a new objective here. Fair Blitz, speak with researcher Gwen to get a lab coat 0 out of 4. So I'm going to have a look on my map. Okay, so is that the exclamation mark due north of us? Is that where we need to go?
It's the one.
Okay, so what is she talking about here? We have to get a lab coat times 4. I don't get it. Do we have to fight mobs and they drop lab coats? Is that what happens?
No, that's just saying that all 4 of us need to get a lab coat off her.
Oh, okay, alright. So hang on, a lab coat. Why do we need to get a lab coat? Are we going to go in disguise or something?
Yes, we are. We're going to infiltrate Lex Luthor's research camp.
Ooh, awesome. Did you hear that, folks? We are going in undercover. All right, so this is going to be fun. And now, folks in the chat room are asking about our builds. Fair Blitz, let's make our way over to where we need to go, if you don't mind. But along the way, can you tell us about your build? What is your power set? What is your weapon set? Etc., etc.
I'm currently using martial arts as my weapon, along with my firepower.
Okay, so fire, you're a fire tank then?
Yep.
Alright, and oh look, Uno Chaos is saying that he can hear us in Mumble now. Good stuff, mate, that's great. Even though if you can't talk now. Where is everybody? Fair, where are you going? Now, am I heading in the right direction?
Yep, just follow the orange arrow on your mini-map.
Okay, there we go. And look, oh, look at this, folks! We have arrived at the Kent Farm! In fact, there it is. That is the Kent Farm itself. This is awesome. And yeah, I bet you this looks familiar to anyone who has watched the series or seen the most recent movie. Look at that. They've done such a good job here. Well done, SOE. It really does look like the Kent Farm. This is so cool with that sunset in the background there. Let's speak with researcher Gwen. Oh! Alright, so we're now waiting for Mizzle Pilk, and look at that, we've been transformed. We are now disguised as a lab coat technician. Alright, so we'll get out of the way so Ms. Pilk can do the same. There we go. Now it says return to researcher Gwen for a new lab coat if we lose one. Avoid detection and activate research equipment. Fair Blitz, help. What do we do?
Basically, we want to go around this area here, finding all the various stuff that we can tamper with. But there are some LexCorp employees that will come up to us and be suspicious. So if you look at your action bar now, you have various different abilities.
Oh my god, I have two! Hang on, let me see if I can... How do I tell what they are? I can't hover over them if I hit enter. No. How do I actually know what they do?
They basically do the same sort of thing.
Okay, so what do they do? Let me know. Tell me.
Button number 6.
Okay, so number 6...
Basically, 1 to 5, you'll use them when someone's getting suspicious of you and they'll leave you alone, basically. If you want to just test one of them out.
Okay.
Right now.
1... Oh, so that's put me on a... Okay, and they've got a very long cooldown. Actually, do you know what I might do? I might shapeshift back. There we go. With my dual pistols. And go get another one. Oh! I was hoping that it would reset the cooldown. But it doesn't do that. Never mind. Alright, so what do? Do we follow the arrows again, and we're looking for these things that we need to go and grab, right? I mean, do I just follow?
Pretty much.
Okay, alright, well, and I... Oh! Now I'm using a different superpower. Oh, I've got no superpower, so I can only jump. I can't fly or anything. Alright, so hang on. Oh, where do I need to go? Over here. Alright, so
do
what...
Do not bother attacking the enemies, otherwise you'll get transformed back.
Oh, okay, so this is a stealth mission, and... So we're going to sneak in here. Alright, so hang on. These LexCorp scientists, what do? I just need to walk in sneakily and try and use one of these terminals, do I? Oh my god, there's a Doomsday... Doom clone Martha Kent? Martha Kent? Oh good lord. Alright, so hang on. I'm going to sneak in here. Oh my god, no, don't get suspicious. Oh, okay, hit
use
one.
Use one of your abilities.
Okay, there we go. Nothing to see here, scientist. It is just me. Alright, there we go. Activating. Oh, what happened?
And now you can just go around smashing them.
Oh my god, I've been transformed into a Doom clone myself. This is the best thing ever. And what do I want to do? I can use these. Oh, is that Martha Kent? Did I just free yep. Martha Kent?
Yep.
Wow. Look at that, folks. All of the big names are in here now. Okay, now, is there anything I need to worry about? I am a Doom clone. Can I just smash whatever I find?
You can smash whatever you find.
This is epic, folks. This is fantastic. But what about the machines that I have to activate? Like, can I do that as a Doom clone? Or do I have to go back and get a lab coat?
Basically, there were four of those, so that each of us can transform into one of them.
Oh, okay.
Thank you. Saved me.
Look at this. This is super. I can't believe I actually got to be one of these guys. Whoa! Okay, I've got awesome powers and I can leap all over the place. This is amazing fun. Now, do I want to smash these machines as well?
Yes, you do.
Alright. Now, let's get rid of this loot window here. There we go. And I guess I'll also want to free these clones so that their inner self comes back out.
Yep.
Now, is that actually part of the objectives, freeing them?
Yes, it is. We've got to change them back, we've got to just smash the scientist, and we've got to break those machines.
Okay, alright, sounds good. In fact, you can see all of the objectives coming up there. And, oh, let me out! So, revert Doom cloned citizens, and that is 12 out of 30 we're up to now. We've got the relieve scientists from their responsibilities, 27 out of 80. 80? Is that enough? Good lord. That's going to take forever,
well, we
isn't it?
We did one-hit them.
Oh, we one-shot them. Okay, all right.
I'm tired of working for LexCorp.
Right, I've got to say, this is definitely a lot of fun running around as this guy. Now, is there any way I can accidentally, you know, get out of this shape-shifted form, or will I stay in it?
We'll stay in it until the end of this area.
All right, this is fun, folks. You guys who were saying, oh, I haven't been into this instance, you need to come in here. So many different things happen, and it is so much fun. Oh my lord. Okay, here we go. Revert the Doom clone citizens. There we go. 20 out of 30. So we're making our way.
As Uno Chaos was saying in the chat there, you also change back if you die, but that doesn't often happen in this form.
Oh, okay, yeah, because we're pretty strong, if you ask me. Oh, and I can see a shiny. There is a shiny. Now, Lafay Verte, are you still in chat back there?
No, he isn't.
Oh, no. Lafay's gone. I was going to ask him if he's been in here, because I know he likes his story. All right, so I am having the time of my life here, running around as a great big spiky Doom clone, smashing everything in my path with my super amazing abilities. This is awesome, and it is a reason enough just to come into this instance, if you ask me. It is awesome. All right, so 69 out of 80, we're doing very well. In fact, is that the last of our objectives? This is all we have to do now, Fair, is get the last remaining 8 of these guys. Is that right?
Yep, pretty much.
Alright.
So you've got one more to do. And there we go.
And there we go. Now, it's saying that we have to confront... Oh, and I've been dazed. Have to confront Dr. Richards. I'm going to come back over to you guys. Whee! Seriously, running
hey,
around...
Sambo, quick question.
Awesome. Yes?
Did you notice any other names for some of the Doom citizens?
Now, it's funny you should say that, because I remember in the last time we did it, you were telling me there were some really cool names there. Now, I was running around smashing up scientists, so I didn't get to see everybody. All I saw was Martha. But what? Go on, tell us some more. I know that you know some of the Easter eggs in here, so who else could we have freed?
Jonathan Kent.
Oh, so Dad.
Lana Lang and Pete Ross.
Okay, now, come on. Pete Ross. Who is Pete Ross, for those who don't know?
Pete Ross was one of Clark Kent's teenage friends, and in fact discovered that Clark Kent was Superboy, at least in the version I remember.
Right, early there you on. Go. All right, so childhood friends. So all of the Easter eggs are in here for sure. All right, so Fair Blitz. Oh, hang on, we got a friend. Fair Blitz, what do I need to do here? It says that I need to confront Dr. Richards. Why would I want to confront her? Or him, rather, sorry.
Basically, he's our next boss.
Okay, this is it. This is the next boss. Do we get to stay in this form as long as we're alive?
Yes, we do.
All right.
At least for this boss, anyway.
Okay, well, you know what? I'm ready. Hopefully, Uno Chaos and Mizzle Pilk are ready. You're the boss. You're the tank. Go for it. Let's do this thing. Wish us luck, folks. And here we go, cutscene. Fighting. You're not getting out of here alive.
Someone seems to put a box in the way.
All right, now, what is the tactic here, please, Fair Blitz? Is there anything we need to know?
Basically, just beat them up before they beat us up.
Beat them up before they beat us up? I can deal with that, no problem. You know what? It's great being able to be this particular shapeshifter. I'm loving it, absolutely loving it. Now, if I use a potion, a healing potion, will I shapeshift back or will I stay as a Doomsday clone?
I'm not sure, actually. I think you'll stay as a clone.
You'll stay as a clone.
All right, thank you. Little bit of a heal. There we go. Get my power back. Uh-oh. Hang on. We're going to loot. Now, I see a small problem here. I see that my objective has updated. Oh, and I've shapeshifted back. That wasn't me. Is that normal? Is it just run out? The timer?
Yes, it is.
Okay, that's normal.
See, we're all changing back now.
Okay, now folks, have a look at the objective down on the bottom right of my screen and look and read what that says. That's right. It is not a mistake. It actually says the minor little task, just a small task of defeat Doomsday. You have got to be joking, Fair Blitz. How the hell are we going to do that? There is no... It's just four of us. There is no way four superheroes can defeat Doomsday. I don't understand this. Explain.
Plus the four AI that we get as PC allies.
Oh, wait a minute. What do you mean, four AI? Are we going to be joined by four other friends in here?
Yep, we get joined by four other heroes, which I think are Green Arrow, Black Canary,
Steel,
and one more. I can't remember who he is.
Alright, so hang on.
Red Tornado.
I think I heard a Kazin in the background there. Now, I don't know if you've been watching us or not, Kazin, but I'd like you to take a guess as to how many times I have died so far in this instance.
I would guess zero.
Now, you know it's me though, right? It is me we're talking about.
I know it's you, but I also know who's with you.
Oh, I see. Damn, I was trying to trick you. You know damn well that, of course, the team we've got here are fantastic, as would a team of any mighty Super Zeroes be. And that's right.
I
have not died once, so I am absolutely going to flex as well. And I'm also going to strike
awesome.
A pose. There we go. Yes, congratulations to me. All right, but I've got to say, Kazin, now
Super Zeroes have always got your back.
They have. They totally have. But... It's Doomsday now. It is Doomsday, and it is me. And that could be quite a bad combination, no matter how good these guys are. So, Fair Blitz, I'm imagining you've done this a fair few times. What do we need to know? Because if I pan the camera around, apart from the fact that it looks absolutely amazing in here, gawking at the scenery, I can see there's a barn up ahead. What are we going to expect once we get closer up there?
When we first enter the barn, we'll have to take out a few just basic mobs. And then we have to free Doomsday, basically.
Whoa, hang on a minute. Did you say free Doomsday? We're not meant to free him.
No.
It says right here, I'm looking on my screen, defeat Doomsday. What do you mean free him?
We're freeing him just so we can beat him up again.
Free him from his shackles.
Oh,
so
but...
that you can fight him at his full strength.
Oh, okay. All right. That's okay.
Because it would be kind of wussy to fight him while he's still in shackles.
It would. But it's something I would do, because it means I would win. But anyway, never mind. Okay, so I guess without further ado, let's have a time check, folks, and we'll quickly go to the YouTube's chat room. And yes, that's right, Everdark Raven, the game is free to download indeed. has a free-to-play option, and you can download it at dcuniverseonline.com. That is absolutely right. In fact, if you have a look at the description in this live stream, in this video right here, right now, you will see a link directly to their website. Excuse me, I'm losing my voice. And if you guys who are watching are thinking, man, this is such a cool game, how can I play? All you need to do is head along there, download it completely free. Completely free. In fact, it's one of the best free-to-play models I've seen in any MMO anywhere. You can do so much in this game for free. It is not funny. You're going to have one hell of a time. And then, of course, if you purchase anything above $5, you will become the next tier and a whole bunch of other things will unlock for you. And then, of course, you can subscribe if you like, and I do that. And that means you get everything always forever. It's just awesome. But I'm sure you'll agree it's an incredible game with a great combat system. So go along there and download it if you haven't already. All right, Fair Blitz, I'm going to have a swig of my tea. While I do that, are we ready?
I'm ready.
Oh, that's some good tea there. Melbourne tea, for those of you who are wondering. Okay, I'm ready. Hopefully Uno Chaos is ready. Hopefully Mizzle Pilk is ready. Lead the way, Fair Blitz.
So turn the chat.
This is it. All right, there we go. Always ready, he says. Thank you, Uno Chaos. And this is it, folks. We are on the final furlong now. This is the last, well, the last event. And I know there are multiple pieces to this, but wish us luck as we go in to, there we go, explore Smallville. We've got ourselves a feat.
Break so
Fair Blitz, Fair Blitz, what do we need to do here? Do we need to take down these ads out the front here first? Is that the way we go?
It's generally best to, yeah.
Alright, so let's do that first. And of course you can see in the barn up ahead, we've got some terminals. While we take down these ads out the front there, what are those terminals there? Are they the things that are holding Doomsday in place, perhaps?
I'm afraid they are, and we're going to have to use them.
And there he is! Look at that! Defeat Doomsday, we have to take down these terminals by the looks of things. Alright, so get ads coming in as we try to take down the terminals, or do we just go straight for the console there, Fair Blitz?
No, we'll just go straight for the console once we've cleared out this barn, which we appear to have done.
Yep, there we go. And look, I'm not happy about this, folks. We are literally, I mean, he's safe there. He's all protected and safe and captured. What are we doing? We're taking that down. I cannot believe it. And here we go, a cutscene.
The Justice League has arrived. Okay, big boy. Time to go back into your entropy cage.
Okay, Fair Blitz. It looks like we're on Doomsday, but we've got the members from the JLA have come and joined us. Fair Blitz, who has come along to help us out here today? This is amazing.
As you said earlier, we've got Steel, we've got Red Tornado, we've got Black Canary, and we've got Green Arrow.
Green Arrow. Okay, now, also I noticed that someone was trying to... Look at this, we've got Mizzle Pilk, who is trying to do something, trying to deliver something. What's going on in the background here, please, Fair?
Basically, why aren't we attacking... have to weaken Doomsday, because as you can see, we're not doing a great deal of damage to him right now.
No, so what's
so we
happening?
So we have to take this, I think it's Kryptonite in there, to these stations.
Right.
And once we use these things, it'll weaken him temporarily.
Okay, so do I use one right now, or do we have to wait till he's nearby?
You can use them, but it'll only activate once he's nearby, and we got the Kryptonite in place.
Right, okay. So there you go, folks. To recap there, yes, you're fighting Doomsday, but you want to take that Kryptonite there, get to the debilitation station, the power suppressor is being transported, and this is going to help us here put a in Doomsday's defenses. Yep. Look at that. One remains. Oh, massive big knockback there from Doomsday, knocking us nearly halfway across the blimmin' map. That is amazing. All right, so is there anything special we need to know right here? Why has he got a timer over his head there?
His knockback is...
Yeah, it is. It's huge. Fair, why is there a timer?
That timer is how long we have him weakened for.
Okay, so we need to go to town on him right now, am I right?
Yep. They noticed that Black Canary just went down, so we've got to try and revive her when we can.
Oh, okay, now how do we revive? Just go over and hit our use key?
Yep. Duty Chaos has got a backup.
Alright, well done. Folks, it's not just a simple tank and spank. We have multiple strategies going on here. All the while we're being knocked back hugely, like you said, Verte. The Doomsday's knockback is absolutely huge, and of course that's what we would expect from a villain of this guy's caliber. And someone else is down. Who was that? Black Canary or Red Tornado is down again. There are lots of things that we have to consider here. We're trying to weaken him. We're trying to make sure that our fellow JLA party members are up and alive. And we're all Black Canary is down again. Let's see if I can revive her. There we are. Up she goes. And it looks like we are really getting... Oh, and he's returned to full strength. So he is no longer vulnerable. And you can see Mizzlepilk is taking this one. What is Mizzlepilk doing? Are we having to go over to the other station? Is that what we need to do there, Fairblitz?
Yeah.
So is that because we've exhausted the resources of the first station and we have to make our way to the next one, which is still up? Is that right?
Pretty much.
Alright, and meanwhile, is there any point trying to hit on Doomsday like this when he's not in a weakened state?
Well, I'm doing it basically to keep him off you guys.
Okay, alright, so...
And you can still damage him, just not as much.
Right, and it's more to keep him busy so that he attacks you as a tank rather than us as DPS. Alright, so do we want to activate these terminals now?
Yes.
Alright, here we go, folks. You can see the pressure. Is on. The pressure is on, and we've nearly got him down. He is at very, very low health, and someone is down from the JLA. He's being revived right there, right now. We've got Mizzlepilk and myself trying to activate these terminals. When do we know that Doomsday is vulnerable? It's down. Is it now? Can we do this now? Can we take him down? There he is. This is it, folks. Can we take Doomsday down? And it looks like he has fallen. And here comes a motion comic. Congratulations.
Planet Earth. Home.
Good job, guys.
Some may call me alien. Although I was born on Krypton,
Sparta.
This planet is my own.
We had faith.
The place I will defend against any threat, as will my allies. Wonder Woman. Hawkman. Martian Manhunter. And many more. Because for me, Earth's people are my family. And my powers give me a responsibility to help and protect them, even though I cannot always be there. Because this is, and always will be, home.
And there you go, guys. That is a fitting end to a mighty battle here on the Kent Farm in Smallville. We've got ourselves a whole bunch of feats. Let's have a look at the loot that's dropped here. And look at that. We've actually got some purple loots there, some plans. We will greed on those. Congratulations to whoever wins those. Fair Blitz, that was epic, and that was one of the most fun instances I think I've ever been in. You can see over the side there, we've got our JLA team who backed us up as well. In fact, let's go and stand over next to them, guys, while we say goodbye to everybody. That was epic. That was amazing. Fair Blitz, you've probably run this a fair few times. How was that on a scale of 1 to 10 compared to your previous runs?
That was actually a very quick run, actually, compared to what I usually do.
Right, there you go. Well, you know what, I think the only reason that it was a great run is because of the caliber of our teammates, yourself included. So my thanks to Uno Chaos in the background there. Great work, mate. Mizzlepilk, great work to you as well. And of course, Mizzle was on the heels. Thank you. I died zero times, and that is nothing but a testament to the skill and teamwork abilities of the mighty Super Zeroes here. Of course, we were led today by the great Fire Tank himself, Fair Blitz, who didn't have to bring out the D21s, Fair Blitz. Are you feeling okay?
I bought it out once. I just don't think you saw.
Oh, you sneaked one in. You sneaked one in. There you go. I'd also like to thank, of course, everybody who joined us in-game at the beginning of today's show in Centennial Park. We do appreciate you coming out with a show of support. for the mighty Superzeroes here in game. We really, really like that. And of course, you guys watching along from home. Now, if you're watching along after the live stream, thank you for your support of the channel. We very much appreciate that. But if you are watching along right now, everybody in chat, thank you for coming along as well. Because you know what? Looking to the chat room there inspires us to have a great time and do well in the instances here so that we can provide you with some entertainment. And of course, it's great knowing that you guys are watching with us in real time as we do this in the game. And there's Ms. Pac-Man once again. Of course, Fair Blitz, you know what? You look very chill, mate. Get it? Chill. Maybe I should save the jokes till later. What do you reckon? I don't think comedy is my thing. But that is it, folks. Of course, this has been the mighty Superzeroes. This has been Smallville on the Kent Farm. We did the undoable. We took down Doomsday. I'd like to also thank everybody in the chat room. And in fact, I think we're going to get an ear-bleeding goodbye from everybody Sambo. In just a minute. Yes, LaFay?
Thank you, too.
Oh, you are very welcome. It's my pleasure. I absolutely love doing these live events. And of course, I can't wait until the next one. But we do need to get out of here. So I hope you guys enjoyed that. You'll see us in about 2 weeks' time. And I dare say if Chilma's got anything to do with it, it may well have something to do with Christmas. I'm not sure. Now, Kazin, are you going to be around for any Christmas specials that we do?
Sure.
Or I hope so, because no doubt. Now, by the way, Kazin, are you off on holidays? Do you have holidays this year?
I'm sorry, you're cutting out.
Oh, do you have any holidays, any Christmas holidays this year?
What do you mean?
Like, do you get time off work?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Good. Okay, that means maybe we'll be able to play some stuff and get some more live streaming up over the holidays. Really looking forward to that. But in the meantime, folks, we need to get out of here. On behalf of myself, Sambo, Dfinity, we've got Mizzle Pilk, of course, we've got Fair Blitz, Uno Chaos, and everybody who's joined us in the chat room. Take care. Hope you guys are having a great week wherever you are in the world. We do look forward to seeing you next time. We will see you then, and bye-bye.
Bye.
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 Toodle pip.
Beautiful.